I'm Sharlene Gill. I'm a GI medical oncologist from the BC Cancer Agency in Vancouver. I've been involved with CCTG since I started my practice as an academic oncologist, so this is probably my 14th year. Currently, I serve on the GI disease site executive, and I'm co-chair of the colon disease-oriented group. So I think within my area of interest, which is colorectal cancer, the two trials that we're currently accruing to that I'm quite excited about are CO21 and CO27. So CO21 is an exercise trial. It's also known as the challenge trial in patients who've had resected early stage colon cancer. And it's exciting because it's looking at exercise as a therapeutic intervention. So this is kind of a first of its kind CCTG-led international endeavor, and so the results could be practice changing with a novel paradigm in terms of trying to look at exercise to improve outcomes. And the second trial I'm interested in is more conventional idea of a treatment intervention, but it's looking at patients with high risk resected colon cancer. We know these patients have poor outcomes even with standard treatment, so it's looking at combination of FOLFIRINOX, which is three drugs given in the adjuvant setting, versus our standard of FOLFOX. And we're doing this in collaboration with the Unicancer group in France. And again, I think this really has the potential to be practice changing in patients where there's an unmet need, where the current standard is not achieving good outcomes. What we need to do better than what we've currently been doing is to try to really be more precise about the patient selection and try to create greater opportunities for biomarker-driven trials. I think in GI, that's a huge opportunity. So I really see, if we want to call it precision oncology, but I really see precision oncology-driven trials as the way in which we're going to be moving things forward. It's not really one treatment for all comers anymore.